if you look at the future, Gen AI at scale and AI at scale and agentic workflows that are coming our way at speed, all of that relies on high quality data at the right frequency, at the right granularity, in the right moment, for the right user. And the fascinating thing about it is when you start geeking out on it, you get into the guts of the business. How does the business work? I'm Vlad Lukic, and you are not hallucinating. It was fascinating for me now to see over the last 9 months or so, when you go through some of the data conversations with the executives and you see there's so much fancy terminology out there, data velocity, data fluidity, that is coming at speed at a lot of the techies, that they're using that in their big meetings to add more gravity to it. But in the end, it obfuscates, right, the basic business conversations that need to have. So don't fall into the trap of those conversations without the clarity. As the CEO, you first need to articulate what are the business objectives and outcomes you're driving for, and that becomes the true north for anyone that touches or talks about data. Like, you gotta follow the rhythm of the business and where the bottlenecks are, and then direct the effort of using the right data to solve those pain points. A lot of the executives don't do that because they start the meetings with their executive teams and their tech teams that say, we need to approve the following tens of millions of dollars to build the following data lake. We need to build the following pipelines. And then there's this new solution from the cloud provider of your choice, et cetera, et cetera. And so as a result, people kind of get intimidated and they step back and they abdicate the thinking on the first principles, which are, what are we solving for? What is the business outcome we're driving, right? And my big message to all the executives is, do not abdicate that conversation, because that becomes the true north for everything else.